वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिसेस पाटिल यसड़ी फ्रॉम AGM कॉलेज कराड़, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अवर यूनिट नंबर 3.4, स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्पस। 3.4 स्टेटमेंट ऑफ पर्पस। Or it is also called as SOP. Firstly, we are going to solve icebreakers. See page number 153. First question, match the professions with the desired qualities. Match the professions with the desired qualities. In the first column, professions are given, and in the next column, qualities of the profession are given, and we have to match the pairs. Now I will read first column. In the first column, profession column, first is businessman, second artist, third advocate, fourth police, and fifth science. Now I will read column 2, qualities. A, reading, experimenting, researching. B, alert, investigative, love for physical activity. C, convincing, selling, risk taking. D, imaginative, creative, thinking out of the box. And last one is logical reasoning, oratory, and critical thinking. First is businessman. See, businessman must be convincing, selling, and risk taking. Which are the qualities of businessman? Businessman, see, convincing, selling, and risk taking are the qualities of businessman. So, see, second is artist. Which are the qualities of artist? See, imaginative, creative, and thinking out of the box. So you can write here D. Then third one is advocate. Which qualities are essential for advocate? Logical reasoning, oratory, and critical thinking, means E. Then police. Which qualities are essential for police? Alert, investigative, and love for physical activity. So B. And last one is scientist. Which qualities are essential for scientist? Reading, experimenting, and researching. So you can write here A. In this way, we have matched the pairs. Our second question is, what is your career goal? You can write here, I want to become a successful person, I want to become a doctor, I want to become an engineer. You can write anything. Then our third question is, which of your qualities would help you in achieving your goal? I will repeat the question. Which of your qualities would help you in achieving your career goal? See, my career goal, you have to write qualities essential for it. 4 points are there. You have to write 4 points. Which qualities are essential? Suppose you want to fulfill your goal, there must be positive thinking.
must be positive thinking.
Second quality is never say die attitude.
Never say die attitude.
Then perseverance.
Perseverance.
Then healthy lifestyle is essential. Then simple living.
Simple living is also essential.
Then you must be ready to do teamwork if you want to achieve your goal. Then you must be a good listener. Then excellence. See, if you want to fulfill your goal, career goal, which things are essential? Positive thinking, teamwork, be a good listener, excellence, never say die attitude, perseverance, healthy lifestyle, simple living. All these are the things essential for achieving your career goal. Then last question in our icebreakers is list the obstacles which might hamper in achieving your goal or goals in life. One is done for you. I will repeat the question. List the obstacles which might hamper in achieving your goal. First one is given in your textbook, lack of proper guidance. And you have to write, you can write lack of family support. Then lack of proper training. You can write lack of money. Means, see, lack of proper guidance, lack of family support, lack of proper training, lack of money. All these are the obstacles we have to face in achieving our goal. Now, what is statement of purpose or SOP? See, page number 154. A statement of purpose is an application made to a university to seek admission to a particular course. See, statement of purpose is an application made to a university to seek admission to a particular course. See, statement of purpose is an application made to a university to take admission. admission to a particular course. It is an essay which describe you as a person. See?
SOP
describes you as a person. Then next one is, it describes your aims and ambitions.
Aims and SOP describes you as a person. It describes your aims and ambitions.
Then it speaks about your journey of life.
Journey of life.
Then, and the qualities you have nurtured in the process.
Your qualities.
The scorecard or the transcript gives you your academic achievement.
It is
objective, but SOP gives an idea about your innate qualities, and it subjective in nature. The SOP gives you an opportunity to show your special qualities, which make you distinct from others. Means SOP shows your speciality. SOP shows your speciality. It explains why you want to join the course.
Means your purpose. Okay.
Then, see, what are your likings? Then, how you have developed your liking? It justifies how you will be able to achieve your aim. It also explains why you have selected a particular university. Then the SOP is a gateway to career.
Is a gateway to career.
Then see, it is gateway to career. The SOP is a gateway to career, as the admission committee judges you or screens the application on the basis of the SOPs received here. So SOP is a very important document.
See, I will repeat. What is SOP? Statement of purpose. SOP, it shows you as a person, shows your aims and ambitions, your journey of life, your innate qualities. It shows your academic achievement. It throws light on your speciality, purpose behind it, and it is very important document, which is a gateway to career.
Now we are going to see the format of
SOP. Format of SOP. Format of SOP.
See, the statement of purpose should be written in around 500 words.
There is word limitation.
500 words. Tentatively
5 to 6 paragraphs. See, 5 to
6 paragraphs. Now,
how you can begin your SOP?
At the beginning, you have to write
first point. At the beginning, you have to write your introduction. See,
begin with your introduction. Talk about your personal background, your mental makeup, and your aim in life.
Means in the first paragraph, you have to write your introduction, your personal background, your personal background, and your aim.
Okay?
In the first paragraph, you have to write introduction, your personal background and your aim.
Now, in the second paragraph,
paragraph number 2.
In second paragraph, the second paragraph should speak about your wish to join this specific program or course and your area of interest.
In the second paragraph, you have to write about your wish, why you want to join this university, and next point is your area of interest, in which field you are interested. Your area in interest. Okay. Then in the third paragraph, see, in the third paragraph,
write about your qualities, what would be helpful or suitable for the career, goal or objective. Show how your hobbies and extracurricular activities would be helpful in strengthening your goals. Means you, in the third paragraph, we have to focus on your personal or innate qualities.
In the third paragraph, you have to throw light on your qualities.
Next point is, you have to highlight your hobbies.
And last one is, you have to write about your extracurricular activities. Extracurricular activities. Okay. Now, paragraph number 4, fourth paragraph of SOP.
In the fourth paragraph, mention your experience in this field or any internship or project you have done. You can state something which make you distinct from the others' application. Means, in the fourth paragraph, you have to write about your experience in this field. Second point is, you have to tell about the project,
about your project or entrance.
And last one is, you have to write about your specialty. You have to show how I am different from others. Okay. Then concluding paragraph.
In the concluding paragraph,
see, in concluding paragraph, state how admission to this particular course, university, would be beneficial to you and how you look at it from a long-term career perspective. In the concluding paragraph, you have to state how admission to this particular course or university would be beneficial for you. Okay. Then
there are some tips
which you have to keep in mind while writing SOP. Write the statement of purpose in clear and lucid language.
Means language of SOP must be clear and lucid. Clear and lucid language.
Then, don't make spelling or construction mistakes.
Spelling and construction mistakes are not allowed. You should avoid it. Should be avoided. Should be avoided.
Then you should be convincing. Means your language should be convincing.
Okay.
Then show determination in your career. Your purpose.
You have to focus on your purpose.
Then and university should be accordance with your career. Remember students that your personality reflects through your SOP. So you have to highlight your qualities. Highlight your qualities. Very important. You have to highlight your qualities, your life experiences. Life experiences in such a way that your application should stand out from the rest. See, your SOP is very important document. It is a gateway of your career. So you have to use clear and lucid language. You should avoid spelling and construction mistake. Your language should be convincing. You should mention your purpose. You have to highlight your qualities and life experiences so that your SOP will become powerful. See, in your textbook on page number 155, there is one sample example of statement of purpose. You have to read that example very carefully at your home. You have to read it for 2 or 3 times. And now I am going to give you one format of SOP. Open your textbook, page number 157, question A2. See, you must have decided your aim in life. Which institute or university would you like to join for your diploma or graduation? And question is like this. Write a statement of purpose as a part of your application to the institute or university. See, I will write the question. See, write a statement of purpose as a part of your application, part of your application to the university or institute. I think now we have discussed icebreakers. Then what is SOP, steps of writing SOP. And so I am going to read the SOP as a part of your application to the institute or university. See our beginning. It is said that education is one of the most powerful things in life. It allows us to find the meaning behind everything and helps improve lives in a massive way. Start from the beginning. I am interested in English literature. I like to enjoy each and every type of English literature, novel, drama, poetry, and short stories. My English teacher, Professor S.M. Jagtap, is my inspiration. It is the supreme art of teacher to awaken joy in creative expression and knowledge. In the beginning, we have written some sentences or quotes related to education. Then we have written our field of interest, that is English literature. Then we have written name of our teacher. You can write any name from whom we have taken inspiration. Then we have written 1 or 2 sentences about our teacher. Then next paragraph, I think we have you can understand it. In the second paragraph, we have written, in my school, we are following all the steps of SOP. Beginning, I think you have understood. First paragraph. In my school and college life, I was very active in literary writing. I have won many prizes for literary writing. I worked as editor of college magazine. I have shown my skill and innovative ideas in the college magazine. I have taken participation in language and literature quiz and have always won the first prize. It is my ambition to learn more literature to expand my outlook and perception. In this paragraph, we have written our field of interest. Then you have focused your innate qualities, how you are extraordinary, how you are special from other students. Then we have written about your achievements. Okay, now I will read next paragraph. I want to do research in the field of literature. I want to research innovative ideas and techniques in this field. I want to develop my career as a critic and researcher in literature. I am ready to take efforts to achieve my goal. I need good guidance for it. In this paragraph, we have written in which field you are interested, then what you want to do in this field, then which things are expected from that institute, and in the last paragraph, I am sure that I will be able to achieve my goal if I get admission in your reputed college in the Department of Language and Literature of English. In this way, you can write SOP. Once again, I will repeat. In the first paragraph, while writing SOP, in the first paragraph at the beginning, you have to write your introduction, background and aim. In the second paragraph, you have to write your purpose. In the third paragraph, you have to highlight your qualities, hobbies and extracurricular activities. In the fourth paragraph, you have to focus on your experience, your project and your speciality, and at the end you have to in the concluding paragraph you have to tell that university, how that university or institute is beneficial for you. Okay students, I think you have enjoyed this lecture. Try to write some samples of SOP. It is very easy to write SOP. Thank you.